Morning.
Good morning.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you. How are you?
Great.
So
really weird.
Do what?
Sound weird.
Hold on, my headset's not working. Let me get my headset. Okay. Talk to me.
It sounds real airy.
Okay, no, you're not my headset. Hold on, I gotta get my headset to work.
Oh, yeah, that's what it is. It's because we can hear you through your computer still.
Hold on. Talk again?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah.
No, I'm going to log off and log back in, okay?
Okay. Good morning, Michelle. Good morning, Eva.
How are you?
Great. How are you?
Doing good. Much better. I had a pinched nerve in my neck all weekend, so.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Saturday was not exactly the way I had planned in the pool.
Right.
Flat on my back.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, that's horrible. So you weren't even able to enjoy convention like we were.
No.
It was actually pretty awesome.
It was. I listened to it, but I just either flat on my back or trying to figure out a position to
it would be the least miserable end. Wow, that's horrible. Well, convention was great, guys. I thought, for what they had to work with, just being online and, everybody here, there, and everywhere, I thought they really made it come together really well.
You was outstanding.
Yeah. Really. Good.
Sure was.
Anything just jump out at anyone that they want to share or plans for the future because of the announcements or what? Just throw it out there.
Yeah, we got to try the new products and I'm waiting for them. I already ordered them.
Right.
See which one. I think I'm going to probably lean more onto the peach for on.
Yeah.
So let's
that's
see how
exciting.
That goes.
That's a neat product. And, I think James Bradford said on the Team Fusion call to maybe if you're not used to caffeine, take it slow. Start out with like a half a bottle. Or, if you are used to caffeine, maybe take that caffeine out of your diet that you have been doing, like coffee, and maybe switch, take a cup of coffee away and add, your on shot. So,
yeah, because I'm one of them. I'm one of them that I cannot take caffeine. So it's going to be a challenge for me.
Okay.
You have really to need to dilute it.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, that's
definitely
another cool idea.
With water.
I liked that idea with the he does it with the sparkling water, but you can do it with water or sparkling water. Make it a treat. Make it a that could be your little cocktail early in the day. But just make sure it's early in the day.
Early in the day. Yeah.
So this is something we're gonna have to figure out how it works for us, but I'm excited about it, as well, because there are so many people out there that like those type things, like those energy drinks, and they've got to have some kind of boost of energy. So I think that this is something that's probably going to do well, and they've got it like they're doing, the limited time right now to see how it does. You know, so they probably just made a certain amount of them to see how it does. And if it does well, you know, if they see the reorders and stuff coming in, it might be a full-time product. So kind of an interesting thing that Travis Garza has set up with the limited time trials like that.
Yeah,
you know, it's kind of good and bad, because if it's something that you really love and it doesn't make the list, then or you've got, or even worse, you've got a customer that really loves it, and then it's like, it's discontinued. But we'll see. I'm sure Kiani always does the right thing, and they've got a lot of research behind it. So
there's a lot of us that won't be able to take the caffeine. I know.
I was about to say, since I can't really take, well, not really recommended for me to do caffeine, would on even be a good idea?
For you, probably not. You know, I would just maintain your wellness, Candace, and, you know, because the main thing is that going through this and being able to do the triangle of health, right there, and how, what all that does for you is, you don't need anything extra, you know. They, in fact, you're right, they do kind of steer you away from any kind of caffeine or stimulant or anything like that, with, you know, because you're,
yeah.
I need to still use the HL5, Candace, like I'm looking forward to trying the new HL5 too.
Right.
So that's something you can still use as a tea, because I put mine in my tea anyway. So
yeah, and I really liked that, you know, that idea for helping people sleep or whatever too, with the tea in the evening, the HL5 tea.
Mm-hmm.
Because my grandfather.
That's excellent. Mm-hmm. That is really good.
Mm-hmm. I don't know about y'all, but when I saw the new on come out, I could think of all the people here at work that have an energy drink in their hand. Oh my gosh. And how many times I've told them, you know, that's not good for you. So now, you know, well, I need, you know, I was like, okay.
You got the alternative.
So now I got something, yeah, to go back to them and revisit that, because they weren't interested in what I had. So,
yeah.
Okay. I got them now, hopefully.
Super awesome. That's
so
great.
I have a question.
Yes.
It's been a while since I enrolled anybody as a business partner. How long does it take to show up in your volume after you place them?
I don't know.
I don't know. It's been a while, so
yeah.
It hasn't shown up yet.
Is your business partner on the call yet? Who do we have?
Not yet. I'm going to send it to her. I meant to do it this morning, but I will. She's wanting to plug in. She's already earned her badges and stuff. She's on it.
That's fantastic.
She's super excited. We sent her those two, awesome. You know, Jim Rohn and the Rise of the Entrepreneur. We had a little meeting, Jake, myself, and Candace with her, because she had some questions. And right away, she enrolled. I mean, she wrote on the highest. I was surprised, the highest packet. So
yeah, that's awesome.
That is, and she's making
that's
a commitment.
Awesome.
So yeah, she's super excited. And I just want y'all to know, it's all about planting seeds. She was one of my coffees back in September, October, when we were doing the coffees. Mm. And we just did a quick coffee because she's got like four kids. So she's a busy mom, stay-at-home mom. And I just kept on, you know, checking on her because she wanted to try the products then, but I don't know what happened. She just, no telling, but anyway, it doesn't matter. But she's the one that became a customer a few weeks ago, got the couples pack, and I plugged her in to several, of our, whatever, the overviews, and, she wanted her husband to see, and then she was at the convention Friday and was very excited. She was, oh my God. I said, can you imagine doing that live? I said, we got to get you a ticket for next year. So
yeah.
Definitely working on her.
Fantastic.
So,
that's great.
A couple things, Claire. Number one, if you still have her in your holding tank, she's not going to show up on your volume.
She's not. I placed her. Oh, I already placed her. So that's what I was surprised.
Second thing, you're only getting 200. I said, you're only going to 200 TV for the next 5 months.
Mm-hmm.
When they buy the big package, you don't get it all at once.
Yeah.
Is that what it is?
Okay. So, yeah, it's not all at once. It's going to be because it's that the $2,000 packet, it gives you 500?
200 a month for 5 months.
I thought it gave you 500 the first month, and then
because maybe. It said the Q on there, it said the QV was 500, but that's what she gets, right?
No, you get the same.
She'll get the 500, but when I go to her, shows zero.
Is that Jake talking?
Yeah, he's with me.
It all rolls up, and it takes time. So the her numbers should be factored into all of our numbers already, but it takes a few days to actually show up in her personal spot.
Okay, because I didn't see it under her. That's what I was concerned about, because I went to where I put her in the genealogy, and I saw her, but everything was zero, and that's what I was concerned. I would say, well, did we do something wrong? I want to make sure we didn't.
It takes time to register in the system.
Yeah.
I didn't hear you.
He said it takes time to register in the system.
Okay.
And
thank you. That's fine.
I can remember it being the last one I enrolled was, Monique, and she came in at the $2,000 packet as well. And it's spread out over, a few months. But, it really is an awesome deal to have it set up like that, because then that way you're, pretty much, you've got a great base to build on. So over the next few months. So it's a great opportunity, to take advantage of. So.
Okay. Well, I still have one more that is considering, I'm going to talk to her today. She was supposed to be on there on Friday. She was not as motivated as Alma. So we'll see, but I'll place her under Alma whenever. It was whoever came first was going to get the person,
right?
Other person.
Right.
I was not going to hold it, because I told Erin that I was going to, she had the opportunity to have the other guest on under her, but the other guest jumped on it. I'm not going to, penalize her for. So, yeah.
Right. No. Yeah, and you're right. Alma, she's showing on there, but it was zeros on everything.
Yeah, so you can see it as well. Okay, good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'll just keep an eye on it and do it.
Yeah.
So I have one more question, and I'm going to mute my phone. sorry, y'all, but this has just been a great weekend for me. My question is, Drive with Five, who's participating? I know that I'm going to get Alma on, it's going to be Candace, Jake and I would, Candace and Jake is considered one, and then me and Alma. So we have two spots open, and I know, but Kathy, you said you had two spots open.
I have two spots open as well. So, and has everybody on this call plugged into somebody or not?
No, I haven't.
I haven't either.
So y'all can put me wherever y'all need me.
No, I haven't either.
Terry, actually, I was thinking about, I've teamed up with Jason and Kyle, and I thought of you, and I didn't know, if that would be, if you had any plans of being with any other teams or what, and I didn't know if Susie, what are anyone's thoughts on that?
Well, I'm not sure what Susie's going to do, because she's just busy with all kinds of other things right now, so I'm not sure how active she's going to be.
Okay.
But I definitely would like to be on a team, and that
or
team
CC, maybe CC.
I don't have anything else tied in right now. I haven't heard back from CC from the weekend, so I'm reaching out to her today.
Okay. Well.
Hey. Oh, go ahead.
Yeah. Well, I think, you and CC would be, I was just thinking you're, since, yeah, I don't know. You can think about it, but it's me, Jason, Kyle. They were both Kyle. I don't know if y'all even know who these people are. Jason is Jason Trott is in Florida. Kyle Trott is in California, and both of them were plugged in for. You know, Jason's been plugged in for a long time, but he's had some life changing things going on. And Kyle has definitely had some life-changing things going on. You know, Kyle is has been in California. He's been doing acting. He's been doing massage therapy. You know, he's out of work right now. So Kyle is so plugged in. He was at the convention, and he has been messaging me ever since. He's got, you know, 40 people on his list. He plans to get through those this week. You know, he's, how do I reach back to some of those people I talked to? So, you know, when you're hungry, you do the work. So.
Gotta be hungry.
I gotta be hungry, yeah, for sure. So, I'm super excited, but I think that, you know, between all of us, we can find room for, you know, whoever. But well, I gotta be hungry.
Put me on your team. I'll be on your team.
I'm happy to be. Yeah.
I didn't hear what Michelle said.
I say, Claire, if you want to put me on your team, sign me up.
Okay. Okay, Candace, you got that? You're going to do it, right?
Yeah, I'll do it.
We got to come up with a name. Okay. And Beverly, are you interested?
Too. I'm sorry, Claire?
I was asking Beverly. I think Beverly's on.
I'm on.
Is that Beverly?
Yeah.
I sent you a message. Do you want to join us? Yeah.
I think you guys can hear me for some reason.
We can hear you now.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah, I'm interested. Okay, Candace, that's us then. Okay. I guess he's good. Okay, thank you. So who do we got to place now? We got to find teams for money.
Okay,
like
Kathy, put me
up.
Yeah, Kathy, I'll be under you then. Kathy, I'll be under you.
Well, I think I'm going to have, I think if we have Terry, and then we need to get with Cece first, because otherwise we'll lose her. I don't know. I mean,
I think Cece and I need to be in the same place, wherever that is.
Exactly.
Yeah. Working with Kathy or either way would be awesome.
Okay.
I can just reach out to her. I've been in touch with her all weekend. I just haven't heard from her in the last 24 hours.
Okay. Yeah.
I think it was a
good Terry, time. Let her know that Alma was placed under Shandi.
Oh, really? Oh,
maybe awesome. Maybe we can wake up Shandi.
Right. Right. Yeah.
That's awesome. That was a recommendation from Casey. Mm-hmm.
That's awesome. I appreciate that.
Mm-hmm. And so when Aaron enrolls, Aaron will go under Alma. So.
And, you know, too, there was, you know, you can strategize how you want to, but also you can also reach up to, you know, as far as, you know, anybody that's in this organization with the Kairos, because we're all part of Miles' team, you know, so you can think about it that way too, because I was seriously considering something like that. David Daniel has I think he's got two spots still. He's got him and Joanne and Crystal so far. So he has two spots still. I didn't reach out to Casey to see what he has going on. But, you know, I'm the competitive side of me jumps in. And I know right now David's more competitive than Casey. He's in a better spot to be competitive. So anyway, so that would be, that's an awesome fit. And if, Beverly, if you haven't plugged in with anybody, David Daniel would be a freaking awesome one to plug into. Because
wait a minute, I just got Beverly.
Oh, you got Beverly. Okay, sorry.
That's the competitive side of me.
Yes.
Come on.
I'm the one that I don't have anybody
right over me.
Oh, okay, Eva. Yes.
Eva. And Rob. I don't know about Rob.
See, technically, our team has six people.
You should just. No, you're cheaters.
People.
We're not cheaters.
Cheaters.
Well, actually, they got seven if you count baby.
Yeah, we got seven.
That's the motivator right there.
But, you know, some of the things that you can think of, to what can you do to help your team? Whatever team you end up on, wherever you end up, make sure that you try to maximize all your points. So how do you get points? You enroll for the next event. That's an easy one. So go ahead and get that done. Claire, you're already coming to the table with a lot of points because, you know, new business partner, the max package. You know, I don't know. I need to print off all the rules and everything for the Drive with Five. But it's just important to, you know, get that going. We've got, we have to sign up by May 24th and make that happen.
So, I have a question. Do you know if it said if you register your ILA ticket or you buy your ILA ticket?
Buy.
Okay. Because if we buy a three pack, it would only count towards the person that bought it.
Right.
Oh, we better buy individual. We gotta get the points. You gotta weigh it.
Actually, we'll ask because. Like that doesn't make sense. If you're buying three,
you should get enough for 3 points. Three, right?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's a good question, and I didn't know the answer to it. And I wanted to go ahead and just get my ticket, so I got my ticket.
I haven't got mine yet.
I started to get the three pack and just tell Rob he's going, but then I thought, you know. Every time you have a new business partner sign on, you have that certain amount of time that you can get the extra tickets. So I thought I'm just going to do it that way. And because there were so many things to buy all at the same time, I got my homecoming ticket. I got the new product. I got the, you know, Salt Lake City. So you just kind of make it work. And, you know, and my husband has this mass pay cut. It's been real fun. You know, you just figure things out. So, but make sure you do everything that you can to maximize your points. And make sure if you're in a team, you're going to get your minimum of 25 points. You know, minimum of 25 points for you to earn your 500, if the team wins. So you...
Everybody. Yeah, 250 points collectively to get $500 each.
Right. Yeah. So definitely do your part. Well, 25 points is to even get
minimum.
You know, so like one person on your team can't get all the points for everybody. Everybody has to have a minimum of 25 points. So. But do everything that you can to get your 250 points. What else did I want to cover? The Road to Diamond. And, you know, it's like, okay, that's already almost sold out. That's crazy. So you have to be a Sapphire to even participate in that. So we got to kick it up and do it by... this month.
Well, rank up is one of the points for the points too, so you got to rank up, you get more points for the higher you go. So that's an incentive there.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And business growth, you know, sponsor. I didn't know that. What did I get? I would get 4 points, I guess, for 4 or 5 points. But that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all can get the business part and you get points.
Right. Right. The 90-day challenge. Rob did a great job. I don't know if he's on anymore or not, but he did a fantastic job of putting his before and after pictures on Facebook. I know that we were posting on there, but I know that he also had some other people posting on there. And that's, you know, that is a great idea to actually just share that, you know, I did this. I didn't win, but I did it. And these were my results. So I was like, dang, you know, that's cool to have that, you know, conversation going. You know, he's definitely going to have some people saying, wow, you know, how did you do that? What are you doing? And have that great conversation going. You know, another thing, we're right out of the event convention. So start over like it's brand new. Like I told you, Kyle has his list of 40 people going that he's already planned on getting through this week without me saying a word to him. It's like, you know, he's just starting fresh. Plug into everything that we can plug into. Let's end this month strong. It's already the 18th. So, but it is a long month because it's, you know, and we've got Memorial Day in there. So we've got maybe some chances to talk to some friends and stuff.
I have a question. Okay. Does anybody know if they've heard any testimonials on dermatitis? Particularly like hair, massive hair loss. And a lady in our tool group from church group, we saw her yesterday, but she has, I mean, I don't think anything else is medically wrong with, well, that's what they diagnosed with her, but I mean, it's like major hair loss.
Wow.
Like almost bald, but I mean, she still has hair.
Wow.
And it's not
nice on the shampoo. I mean.
Yeah, well, do they have her on medication?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is any of it topical?
I don't know.
You might be able to put her in touch with Rob's customer if there's not a testimony on the testimonial page. Rob's uh-huh. customer has had really good results.
Does she have dermatitis?
I don't think so.
No. He'd gone through colon cancer and lost a lot of hair. I just started him on the HL5 and the Nitro. And I picked up 4 of the customers just from him because his results were so amazing. Of course, I was training him. So he's exercising, getting fit. But I've had him on some different products. But that dermatitis is something different.
Okay.
I mean, he had his hair grow back and it got darker. And he works at a day spa and they were all asking him if he had had a hair transplant. And no. The owner of the day spa spent $20,000 on hair plugs and they didn't work. So everybody wanted to know how he got his hair to grow back. And I saw a picture of him September 5th of 2019 and he was bald except for a little small patch on the back of his head and some on the sides. So his hair has been growing back and it's just a natural.
That's awesome.
Wow.
And Candace, if you need anything, I can do a good testimonial on just hair growth. I haven't lost any hair, but like my whiskers and my hair on my head, I have to cut them twice as often now because they just grow like crazy with the triangle and the HL5.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, yeah. And everybody with their, you know, you're right, Terry, with the triangle of health, just the just having the proper nutrients in your body, and your body does what it's supposed to do. So, you know, my fingernails, my hair, you know, everything is, you know, what did they used to do? What was that? Horse and mane or something, when back when it seems like
gelatin pills or gelatin pills for the nails. I remember
all that kind of stuff.
I remember my cousins used to do all that.
Yeah, people used to do all of that stuff and ask, you know, are you doing that? You know, no, you know, it, but as and my nails would always, you know, they'd get this length and they'd break. Everybody's got no nails right now because the nail salons, but they still look decent to not have any nails. You know, they're still strong, and that would not have been the case before the triangle. You know, after you've had nails, girls know this, after you've had, you know, acrylic or I had shellac, after you've had all that stuff on your nails, they become real thin. And mine are not, because of the triangle of health. And that's the same thing with your hair. Those nutrients, you can tell when people's hair is healthy or not. And that's where you're gonna, you know, you'll see it more if they're getting the proper nutrients. And so the triangle of health would definitely help anybody. So, you know, I would start with that and then say, you know what? And some people put that nitro in their hair and their shampoo, and it's really helped them. So, yeah, the triangle of health, she can add that to whatever she's doing. But if they've got her doing something topically with her scalp and her hair, then I would steer clear of telling her about the nitro and the shampoo. But, you know, the nutrients will definitely help her regardless.
Oh, yeah.
I would share that with her. What do y'all think about the timeline with the 120-day timeline with the new stuff coming out and some of the stuff being limited? I got to tell you, my first reaction was not good. But these people.
Why is that, Kathy?
Because I mentally went back to a situation where you're stocking inventory, and we do not do that. But I went to that place and it wasn't good, because once that limited time is over, the company doesn't advertise for those products and you're stuck with them. So that's where I went. And I was like, this is Kyani. They know what they're doing. And when the person places the order, and if it's not there, it's going to say out of stock, you know, discontinued, whatever. And that's not something I have to deal with. Then, you know, we could try to see if anyone has any on hand or whatever to help our person out. But by then they may have come out with something even better, or they may, you know, if it's in high demand, they may bring it back, or they may never discontinue it. So I had to wrap my brain around, you know, this is Kyani. It's different. It's, you're not stuck with inventory that, you know, they're not advertising anymore. You know, it's going to be on our website for people to order from our website until it's not. So I think it's fantastic. And then that way they can get an idea of what's really popular.
Yeah.
And just for everybody in the group.
Yeah.
My question to anybody in the group, has anybody ever taken those 5-hour energy shots, number one and number two? How much does those cost?
I have, yeah. And I've got
$3.49 per unit, $3.49. I just saw them at a gas station yesterday.
Thanks, Jay.
Yeah. And they were like $4.95 at, you know, other establishments I've seen them. And I've taken a couple of them over time, but it was more from people that I worked with that was taking them, and I would ask questions. So, like Claire. So.
I've taken them. I took one on my drive up to El Paso. It didn't hit until I got there, and I laid down to go to sleep. My body was buzzing. It was horrible. But and we also have to look at the nutritional value that Kyani's the on brings instead of the right. 5 hour whatever they're called. Yeah. So
I was looking more at the price point. Price point's $5 a bottle.
Yeah.
But the nutritional value that ours brings with it, I think, is worth more too.
And Rob, is ours $5 a bottle our cost, or is that the customer's cost?
I just saw a bottle of six going for $30, or a pack of six going for $30. So
okay. Yeah, I'm curious. I think $5 is a fair price, especially for something that's has the nutritional value that ours does, and all natural, and promotes mental focus. And you know, there's so many things. It's like, I don't know. I'd like to have them side by side.
Yep.
Yeah, and see the differences. So.
Well, the big difference is the adaptogens, okay? And that's what's going to really give people mental clarity. They're going to really feel a difference. There was a movie out a while back where it was Limitless or something. That's kind of the situation, because it's going to be you going to be in the best version of you. I remember them talking about it at Bradford. Somebody said that today, that Travis Karst had mentioned the Russians were using adaptogens in the Olympics and how they could do so much better. So apparently we got a hold of some of the science, and that's what we're offering now, is the adaptogens. That's probably the key thing. You know, there's always like a key component of a product. Well, the adaptogens that there's this possess is really going to bring a lot of mental clarity, more than you've probably ever experienced before.
And what was the Russians used it in what?
The Olympics.
In the Olympics, the Russians were using adaptogens, because we were all just trying to find out how, whether athletes doing so much better.
Yeah, I heard him say that, and I missed it. I didn't write it down, so I just wrote it down. Yeah, that's awesome. That is awesome.
They use hypnosis too.
Did they?
Yep. They've been doing that for 30 years. Everybody has, really.
Wow.
Yeah, nutrition breakthroughs happened for the Olympic teams before they hit the general public.
Wow. Very cool.
And our cost on like the Kyani On is $24.95 for a box.
Okay.
Auto ship price is $21.95, so $22.
Okay. So,
they're about $5 each at cost, I guess, our cost.
Okay, so that's our cost, and there's six in a container. That's $367 a piece.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the customer cost is about $5 a piece, which is, I think we can, yeah, I think that's a good price. That's a good price point, because you know,
the
like
customer
the
cost is $26.95 for the customer's cost. So you $27 for a box for a customer. So what does it come out to be?
I saw it $29.95.
$4.50. No, I'm looking at my back office, and I went to the customer side. Wouldn't that be what the customer sees?
Yeah.
And it's $26.95.
Oh. I'm on the customer side right now, and I'm looking at the main page of products, and it shows $30, $26.95 with auto ship.
Okay.
AutoShip.
Oh, you know why? Because my customer site is AutoShip. Okay, duh. Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha. So it's going to show what the AutoShip is automatically. Okay, I get it. Right?
Yeah.
If I move to my customer site.
Wow.
We'll have to figure it out.
But that's still, it's still great. It's still a good price. I mean, $450, $5. So. Either way, that's a good price for that. Would y'all agree? Or
cause I need to try it first. I want to try it first. I'm still going to try to sell it to these people here. I don't care.
I mean, if you can replace a cup of coffee for one of the shots, you know, instead of going to Starbucks for $5, take that. It's better for you. It's, you know, it's nutritious, and, you know, the price point, I think, is pretty much the same. I think the value is definitely worth it.
Well, one way to pitch this product is, if you know anything about energy drinks, the Monsters and all the rest of them, they drain your adrenal glands. Okay, now if this is an all-natural product, as someone said a while ago, that's going to be totally different. That's another way to pitch this, because again, the damage that the energy drinks that do to you over a period of time, again, it drains your adrenal glands, the fight and flight thing that you have within your body, and that's not a good thing. So you can say, listen, what you're drinking right now is not good for you because it drains your adrenal glands. This won't.
Yeah. And people that are doing so who do you target? You target the people that are doing the Monster drinks. I think of the people that Advocare had a product.
I got our energy.
Called Spark. And so that was for, you know, people that didn't drink coffee, that wanted mental focus and, you know, clarity, and didn't drink, you know, coffee. That was a perfect thing for them. So this would be perfect for, if you know any people that, you know, used to do Advocare, and here ours is just an all natural, shot. And yeah, so and that definitely the people that are doing the Monster drinks, they all need to get off of that crap. It's horrible. So yep. And what was it, I'm dating myself now, anyone remember Jolt Cola?
Yes.
I don't know if it's still out there or not, but I used to work with a guy that drank,
I hope not, but
Jolt Cola. So, yeah.
I remember it. I didn't drink them.
I didn't either. I don't
a tremendous amount of sugar in it.
Yeah.
Yeah, most right, energy drinks are high on caffeine and sugar, but not as high as a Coke, actually. Most of those energy drinks are high on caffeine, like 300 milligrams, which I think ours has, 80 or 100 or something like that in it. And then the energy drinks are also really high on sugar. For a little tiny drink, but they're not as much sugar in them as there is on a Coke, surprisingly.
Yeah. Well, and also, guys, remember 4 max per day. I can't imagine anyone drinking that many, but max of 4 a day, and keep them early in your day. They will keep you awake. I'm excited to get them, and I'm excited to get my HL5, see what it tastes like, the new flavor. But lots of good stuff. And Kiani Pro, do your trainings on that. As soon as you can, try to plug into that and get some training in. Let's figure it out and maximize what they've offered us there, because that's, I was sold with that lady, the girl.
She was so good. Nina, I think her name was Nina.
Yeah, I think so.
Or Merton, yeah.
I'm ready to do a video and do my point and the point down.
We got it. Yes.
She trained at the Diamond University of Dallas.
Yeah. Yeah. She did an amazing job with that and, for our convention. And, you know, it made it seem so simple. It's like, oh, wow, I can do this.
Yeah.
And so I can't wait to be hands on to see how it works. And if, you know, if I really can do it, you know, and to see that those link generator links are just, you know, they're right there, and they're pictures, you know. So you can
I like that. And also, y'all make sure and plug into the breakout sessions. I did the women's forum the first. I'm going to start working on those. And how long do we have them till? For 30 days? Or?
Yeah, so we got another, 28 days now. So, and everybody needs to make sure that their team's aware of those, that we had the breakout sessions. Because, like Betty, I was trying to say, okay, make sure that everybody's getting plugged into all those extra classes. There's plenty of things out there. And I was also going to mention this to Michelle. You know, a lot of Beverly, a lot of people ask about, is this recorded? Is this one recorded? Whatever the event is it recorded? You know, I heard it last week and it was like, it really stuck with me. Don't worry. Don't go back. It's like watching a rerun of a baseball game. Unless it's these things like the convention. Okay. That's different. Plug into those. If you get a chance and you want to watch something, plug into that. But the, you know, sports channels right now are showing reruns of old baseball games or whatever. That's old news. Whatever the recorded event is, it's old. And right now, we've got so many things plugging into, you know, that we can plug into that are new, that are going on right now. That's what we need to plug into. So don't look back for a recording. Look forward for what's the next thing I can plug into. Unless it's convention. Take full advantage of that and take full advantage of the training on our new app. So,
we're supposed to listen to.
Rob, you're cutting out. Old. Talk slower, Rob. You're cutting out.
Yeah, it's AT&T signal strength. I said, I'm sure with your advice right there, you're not referring to Jim Rohn because he's kind of old. I wouldn't want to go back and look at.
No, not the classics. I'm just talking about our, you know, just our little.
It's sometimes during the day it's hard because if I'm not right there with my phone, I can't, you know, listen to it right then and there. So I try to, but sometimes I can't. So
definitely you can always plug into the classics, you know, Jim Rohn, Robert Kiyosaki. Eric Worre, you know, there's stuff that's, you know, Andy Andrews, there's stuff out there that's, you know, timeless. And yes, you can plug into that stuff and, you know, them all. But as far as our meetings and things like that, you know, don't get bogged down in, you know, I missed Heidi's meeting last week on whatever. It's like, hopefully somebody here watched it and somebody has those nuggets that they can pass on to this call, you know, and we can share. And please do, anytime that you have something that is like, oh my gosh, a key takeaway, share it with us. And then that way you can refresh your memory too, even if you were sitting there listening to it. It might be something that, it, just like Rob talking about adaptogens, or was it Rob or Terry, whoever.
Rob. I
think Rob. But it's like, no, you know, I heard that the first time, but I didn't make a note of it. And I didn't, you know, it's like, okay, that's something I need to know. I mean, so thanks for sharing. Anyway, anything, does any of that make sense?
Of course.
I just ramble. I'm sorry. It's like I get it all in within my 30 minutes, which has turned into an hour lately.
That's all right.
Well, speaking of, we do have a Breakfast of Champions call here in 10 minutes.
Yeah. Okay. Awesome.
Is it back to normal now? Thank God.
Are they still doing that? I thought they changed that to the noon.
I think
they did for 2 weeks prior to the convention.
Yeah, until after convention. So hopefully it's back.
I thought at convention he talked about that too.
Yeah, I think it's actually called the Building Champions Call, and it's Monday through Friday at 11 Central, 10 a.m. Mountain time. So it's they've changed it from the Breakfast of Champions to Building Champions Call, BCC.
Hey, somebody took notes. Did you do that, Kathy?
I did.
Good job.
I did too. Because what they said was now they're calling it that because it's not breakfast anymore. It's kind of midday. But they're doing that also because there's so many more countries that are tuning in.
Right.
And it's, you know, all different times of day for them. It might be nighttime or whatever. And so they've changed the name and made it a later date, time day, during the day.
Hopefully other countries tune in because on the average, your Breakfast of Champions call only had about 40 people on it. It's kind of pathetic thinking how good information being given to us and we can only get 40 people out of thousands of organization. It was kind of sad.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you know.
Yeah, it had really dropped off.
You know, you got to also think that a lot of people are, you know, in a work environment. And if you're at a desk, I can tell you, even when I had my headset in trying to plug into something like that, it was frowned upon and I got called to the back a few times. So, you know, so I can understand why.
But you showed them you're retired now.
I know. Read between the lines. Yes. But so I don't get on to anybody for not being on them, but you know, absolutely there's great information. And if you can plug in. But yeah, so the new time, Monday through Friday, 11 Central, 10 a.m. Mountain time. And Building Champions Call. So it's not breakfast anymore because everybody's going to tune in.
Now, did you get that on the Team Fusion call? Because I didn't get that on Friday. Friday call. When did you get that information, Kathy?
That might have been on. I can't tell. It might have been on. It might have even been on Heidi's call. After Team Fusion. It was after Team Fusion, and it might have been at the very end of what James Bradford was saying, or it might have been at the beginning of Heidi's.
One thing I will ask, I know we're just got a couple of minutes here left. I didn't get to hear any of Saturday's calls because I had new clients coming over and looking at equipment, and I'm still trying to book people. So I missed both calls. I think there was 2 hours worth of calls between 12 and noon, and I picked up the first 15 minutes before they got there. So can anybody give out a few nuggets what they picked up on Saturday's calls?
It was Saturday's call, and it was James Bradford. Because I can tell after that there was a note that was also James Bradford. So he talked about, the key things like the Drive with Five and deadline dates and points. And it starts with your rank advance starts with your paid as rank in April. So that's good. So if you've got, you know, new business partners that started in May, it's your paid as rank in April is what we're starting with. Things that get you points or the new business partners, new customers, business builder bonus, your customer builder bonus, buy your event tickets, and okay, so you talked about the 25 points each minimum to even qualify. If you've got a rock star on your team that's blowing up all the points, each member of the team has to have 25 points to, you know, qualify for their $500 part of that. The BCC call, and Beverly did a great job of explaining that, of why they did that. And it's on the team Facebook group. And one of the things he mentioned, and I like this, and your income is capped at your personal development. If you've only got in, John Maxwell says it another way, and so many people have used that in so many different ways, but it's like, if you can't see yourself in, like in his situation, driving a Lamborghini, I choose not to drive a Lamborghini, but my mind's not going to have me say that. My mind, I'm telling myself, you know, if I want a freaking Lamborghini, I can get one. I don't want one. But maybe, you know what, just for the hell of it, I might rent one weekend and drive it around. You know, I have no clue how much money that is, but I don't, you know, I'm not capping myself to, oh, I'd never be able to have one of those. Or, oh, I'd never be able to, you know. So don't cap, you know, and continue to learn so you're not in that small mentality. But he said your income's capped at your personal development. So something to keep in mind. And the Kayani Pro 2, do your training module, the onboarding, and it's got Team Fusion is in that, it's wrapped in there somehow. So you don't have two separate apps. You've got, you know, that app that you can get, you know, it'll recognize us as being part of Team Fusion, and we'll have extra stuff in there that they've
It's a custom made version of the Kayani Pro 2 just for our group.
Yeah.
Which is pretty sweet.
So that's, yeah, interesting. So do those trainings. The upcoming events he mentioned, you know, the Road to Diamond at Alasso Ranch is the August 13th through the 16th. You know, get your tickets now. If you're a Sapphire, get your tickets. They're selling out. That's the thing, the qualification, you have to be Sapphire or above. If you're not, get to Sapphire and get your ticket. Homecoming, $149 goes up at the end of May. And that's in Las Vegas, November 13th and 14th. And then June 13th. So this is the most, you know, the event that's coming up the quickest is June 13th. The online regional event is $10, or it's free with your homecoming ticket. Okay. So June 13th on the online regional.
Well, one thing you need to consider about homecoming is just before GoPro. So you would be going back and forth to Vegas within a month's time.
Yeah. Well, and it kind of was, last year was October, and then we had GoPro in December. So this will just be November, and then we got December for GoPro. So, yes. And I have GoPro tickets. If anyone wants them, through me. If their leader, upline leader, does not have them, I do. So,
how much are the tickets, Kathy?
That's a good question. I'm glad you asked. 300.
300.
300. All right.
Yes.
Kathy, when can I get with you to bring you a check for that, for one?
Oh, no rush. I've got your name on one, Terry. Right. And
put one on mine for me, but I'm just, right now, I'm trying to get things back into swing of things, so. Okay. But I definitely will want to attend.
Yeah. And did I have, I think Claire was the other one. I wrote it down somewhere else. It's not on this page.
And I think Eva was wanting to go too.
Okay.
We talked yesterday, maybe Saturday night. I can't remember. Yeah. But yeah, she definitely wants to. She was afraid she was going to miss something. She saw May something. I said, no, that's next year. You're not missing anything. Nobody's going anywhere right now. So,
right. But
yeah, she wants to stay plugged in, and she wants to go to the events.
That's awesome.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, Kathy, I want you to sell your tickets, but I will pitch to people the online thing that I got to listen to last year. Fabulous, because I got to hear it for another 2 months after that, you know, all the recordings, all the different ones. So there's something to be said if you want to sit at home and listen to it and replay it over and over again.
Yeah, you get that too with your ticket. Being there, they send it to you, the online recording as well. So,
which I did because I was sick,
yeah,
when all that was going on. So I was able to watch it from home, but
yeah,
didn't have to infect anybody else. So that was good.
Yes. Thanks for leaving your corona at home.
Exactly.
Michelle had corona when corona wasn't cool. What is it?
Exactly. You know what? I'm serious. I'm going to find the place where I can go get tested. My mom was like, I said, well, then they'll want me to donate my plasma or something. She says, well, you wouldn't do that? And I was like, yeah, I would. I don't do needles at all. I mean, just, yeah, no, that is not my thing. But I would in a heartbeat just to, I don't know. But I do, I would be very interested to see if that was what I had, because I was sicker than a dog.
I know. My son, too. I swear it was. So.
Yep.
Anyways, all right, guys, it's been good, and it's already 9:02. Get off my screen, holy cow.
That's the way to use a whole hour. Way to go.
Holy moly. Have a great day.
And I are talking in 30 minutes.
Goodbye, John boy.
Bye. Have a good day.
Have a great day, and we'll talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.